Yeah, I mean, I love seeing people worship. I'm addicted to the moments when you watch somebody like realize they're not a puppet of fear anymore, and they begin to break the puppet strings, the things that their whole life they've been told they can't do. You're not creative. You can't sing. You don't have a song. You don't have a voice. You can't dance. And those puppet strings of fear snap as they realize, I'm made for this moment. I'm made to experience this. And they fly out of their little cages of fear and become these cageless birds soaring. And I love watching people have that. Sometimes you can tell they're having that first moment and they're just starting to, okay. And then they fly out of the cage. I think our dream when we go and we lead worship or we're playing out somewhere is, I love crafting and creating songs. My dream is that our songs would not just be sung by those in the crowd, but that our song would wake up the song of the people. Those out in the crowd start singing louder than the sound system. That the song, the resonance inside of them wakes up. And like our song would be like a diving board to get them from here into the heart of God and bounce them into the heart of God. And once they're in there, they're singing their own song. And we're out of a job because they're caught up in their own song and they're even singing louder than the system. So those are my favorite moments.
Does everybody have their own song?
Oh yeah, it's in our DNA strand. I wrote in my journal probably about 10 years ago, I wrote this phrase. Said, I want to look into the eyes of the I Am and find out who I am. And so I feel like so much of what my song is this place of looking into the eyes of the one who made me, and by looking into his eyes, discovering who I am. Our song is this song of identity, this song of I remember who I am when I remember who he is. I discover who I am by discovering who he is.